Peace and blessings, family. Today on Let's Talk Tuesday. Oh, I forgot to get Celia. I got a mic, so I don't know if I'm being extremely loud right now, but I got a mic. I'm a professional. But anyways, today we are talking about, or I am answering questions about the Nation of Islam. Now, I get a lot of questions in my DMs about random things. Sometimes I forget to answer them. I'm so sorry. I get carried away, and there's a lot of times it can get overwhelming. So I figured I'd make this video. This will probably be a part one of part who knows how many. But right now, I'm going to answer just a few of the questions that I got through social media and that I can kind of remember. But if you have any questions, again, just comment below, or you can follow me on Instagram, DM me, Facebook. You can iMessage me. Not iMessage. You can't text me. But you can message me on Messenger about a question. So yeah, let's get right into it. I'd love to hear your take and understanding of courtship, the roles of both man and a woman. What is it like to be an MGT and what this means? And perhaps even give us a small lesson or a small lecture about life, the teachings or personal experiences. Okay, this is like five questions. I'm going to answer probably like three for time's sake. My understanding of courtship and the roles of both man and woman. For courtship, at least, I like to think of it as the step before marriage. Courtship for me is marriage. You're literally going to court. You're literally going to test this person to see if they are the one. Therefore, I have to feel, me personally, I have to feel like this person might have potential. Like, I just gotta know. Allah gotta tell me. It gotta be a sign or something from the universe for me to enter a courtship. And those who are not familiar with courtships, it's something that civilized countries or nations do, because we do not believe in boyfriend girlfriend. That's a waste of time. And we don't believe in sleeping around and just, you know, having fun figuring it out, I guess. No, life is serious. My time is important. I don't care. No, my time is important. So courtship or nothing. We can be friends maybe, but courtship or nothing. Roles of both the male and the female. Do what you're supposed to be doing, and I'm supposed to do what I'm supposed to be doing. Now, as long as I'm staying with my nature and doing what Allah put me on this earth to do, and you doing what Allah put you on earth to do, and you doing your role, balance. You know, that's my viewpoint of that. What it's like to be an MGT? I don't know. It's pretty dope. Yeah, me. I mean, I don't know. I'm just me. I think it's great. Okay, it gives you a confidence that you can't get anywhere else. I 1000% believe in that. I went through school, didn't have this confidence. Grew up 18 years, never had this. I never had this type of wisdom, this type of spirit, this type of beam glowing. Y'all see this? This is from obedience and dietary restrictions and just being a highly spirited person 92% of the time. So yeah, being an MGT is great. I love it. I wouldn't trade it for anything in this world. So yeah. If you'd like to learn more about being an MGT, comment below. I can get you a link, or we can talk again. Let me know, y'all. I'm trying to help y'all, because y'all gotta see this. All right, next question. I want to hear your personal reason why you joined and how you found out about it. Was it hard transition with your family? So my reason why I joined the Nation of Islam, I have a couple of reasons. I was 17 at the time, so my brain was like all over the place. It was between school and this, but I had a sit down kind of moment, and I was like, you know what? I don't know what I want to do in my life anymore. I don't want to go to school. I don't want to go to this white school. That was like my issue. I no longer want to go to school that I wanted to go to, because it was like, I went to the orientation. It was like all white kids. I'm like, bro, I can't do this. I will literally be depressed if I go here. I can't. No. And I changed my life plans. I wanted to be a nurse initially, but then I said, at this time again, when I was planning on going to school and stuff, I was getting into the teachings, as in starting to read and do everything on my own. Now, I always grew up around it because my father was in the Nation, but I did not know everything. I had to learn everything myself, which I'm grateful for, because you are more susceptible and more adhesive to the knowledge that you gain and receive yourself, not necessarily the knowledge that someone gives you. So yeah, I joined when I was 18 years old, and because I initially wanted to be made a woman, What does I mean by that? Of course, I was born a woman, but I wanted to learn how to cook. I wanted to learn how to clean. I wanted to learn how to rear children. I wanted to learn how to act at home and abroad, modesty, all that, because I never really got that growing up, because that was not my example. My mother did not wear feminine clothes. My mother did not cook. All of that stuff. So I initially just wanted to be like the dopest, strongest black woman ever, so that my children could be dope, strong black children. So I'm pretty much doing this for them. But yeah, that's my reason. And I found out about it again through my father. He joined the nation when I was in the womb. The day of my mother's baby shower, actually, is when he joined the nation. The transition with my family was not really hard, because they were used to my father again. And I was just like, oh, no, there's two, kind of. And it's a little different for the females, because, you know, we cover up and we don't show certain parts of our bodies. So those questions come up, of course. But other than that, it was all right. I think my mama had a little issue at first, but eventually she started to not caring when she saw how much I was changing. So yeah, that was that. Thank you so much for that question. What do the women do in the Nation of Islam? Now, that's a great question. I don't know if I can answer that. I can't answer that because I know, but you know, there's different stages in life, different stages for the MGT. You know, some are married, some are have children, some are older and their children are away, so their lives are different. But overall, we do whatever God puts on our hearts to do if we are in tune, and when we are in tune, okay? That means owning business for some of us. That means working for some of us. That means rearing children, being a good or a fun housewife, you know, whatever, really. We can do whatever as long as it does not conflict our religion and as long as it is not demeaning to us in any way, okay? I want y'all to get that straight. We can do whatever, all right? Not like go crazy, but like whatever our creative minds can do, you know. I learned recently that there is power. I don't care what nobody said, there is power in staying at home, and for a woman at least, and to be able to just think and create these thoughts and think about a business and how they can take their family to the next level. Like, I understand why we are taught to stay at home now, because like, man, I never would have got half of the ideas that I have if I was not at home in my own mental space, communicating with Allah and meditating. I'm going to just put that out there. That's for another topic. But why do you love Farrakhan so much? Baby girl, if you knew him, you wouldn't even be asking that question. If you just listened to him, if you seen him in person, tears. But that's another topic for another video. Was Master Fahd Muhammad white? No, he was not. Master Fahd Muhammad was a biracial man. His mother was white and his father was black, and he was made that way so that he could come here and we would listen to him, because you know we were broken at the time. We ain't gonna listen to no black man if they came in our door. So he had to look like he was white and teach us, you know, everything that we didn't lost when we were brought over here by these crazy Caucasians who wanted us to do and do everything that they couldn't do because they were dumb. But anyways, yeah, he was white. No, he was not white. He was biracial, but also not only because that we needed, we were going to listen to a black man, but because he came to bring justice to both parts, the black man and the white man. So yeah, another topic for another video. Do you really believe that God is a man? Of course. Okay. People who have helped me in my life, we're all human beings. Okay. And I've seen Mess Lewis Farrakhan, and I've seen people, the way he's transformed people's lives. Like, ain't no way that is God, though. Like, that's God. He's awakening God in people. Like, I've seen people who were doing nothing, and now all of a sudden they're doing everything. It's beautiful sight to see. I think the fact that I think that, or I know that God is a man, is keeping me here and not all the way up there floating around. Like, it's keeping me stagnant. Like, oh, okay, God is a man, so I can do what God can do to an extent. And just, that's all. Another topic for another video. What is the sisterhood like in the NOI? It's great. I love it so much. One of the greatest experiences I have ever had in my life. I would not be who I am today were it not for the sisterhood, and I love it so much. The sisters that I have in my mosque, they will not let me be mediocre. They will not let me get inside my own head, because that's what I did a lot. They pushed me to be the best me that I could possibly be. All of my I used to have anxiety really bad, and I was really insecure, but all of that is like gone, I think. It hasn't really came up mess with me so far, but all that is gone thanks to these sisters pushing me and making me do things that I never would have actually done to overcome these fears and all of that. So yeah, as y'all can see, I light up after talking about the sisterhood because I just love it so much. And I've never experienced anything like this in my life. And that's why at first I was just a little hesitant. I'm like, bro, why are y'all so nice? Because I'm used to people being mean. That was the way we were when I was in school and all that. But anyways, yeah, I love it. You can ask any MGT about it. They can ramble on about it all the time like me. So yeah, that's all the questions for today. Again, let me know if you guys have more questions. I love talking about the Nation of Islam because it is so beautiful. Ah, I just love it. But yeah, comment below any questions. Follow me on Instagram at lunaralnura, Facebook Anura Muhammad. DM me, message me. I love you guys so much. Thank you guys for watching this video. I don't know what we're going to talk about next week. Let me know. I could do a part two of the NOI because I love talking about it and you guys love listening. So yeah, let me know. Again, I got a new speaker, so I don't know how loud it's going to be. But yeah, catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace. Grace, oh grace, every time you come around, I feel okay. Help me see your love.